going on there.
Why you always in the mood? Fuck around like I'm brand new. I ain't tryna tell you what to do, but try to play cool. Baby, I ain't playing by your rules. Everything look better with a view. Why you always in the mood? Fuck around like I'm brand new. I ain't tryna tell you what to do, but try to play cool. Baby, I ain't playing by your rules. Everything look better with a view. I can never get it.
Hi, welcome back to another video. First of all, happy new year, guys. Decided to do some other sort of content, so we're exploring today. So yeah, this is gonna be the first part of my adventure exploring series. Although we're still in COVID and we can't really go anywhere, I'm gonna try my best to take you around Melbourne, around Victoria, different places. But today on the agenda, we are going to six places that I must visit from Phillip Island. First of all, we're already at our first location. If you look over to this side, this is the Pinnacles lookout. It's at the start of Phillip Island, about 1.5 hours drive from the center of Melbourne. Now this place is quite a trek. So you park at a beach and it's about a 20 minute walk to get to the end of the lookout. We're not going to go the whole way because of time reasons and we have other places to be.
No, it was actually because I couldn't be bothered.
But I'm going to fly my drone over there so you guys can see.
So, just like the 12 apostles, these structures were formed by the harsh weathering and erosion of the limestone caused by the wind and the sea. Long, long ago, these cliffs weren't as sharp, as they used to be one big headland. Now, the weathering here isn't as bad as the 12 apostles, but Mother Nature sure has done some work.
On to the next place. Hey yo, welcome to the forest cave. So here, as you can see, these are sea-made caves, or sea-formed caves. Similar to what we saw before, it's made by erosion. But instead, these caves are, or these rocks are red, and that's because of the volcanic activity. Now, volcanic activity, what that does is that it spews up iron and oxygen, making iron oxides, and that's what makes these rocks red. So this is really close to the place we were before. It was just about a 5 minute drive, just the start of Phillip Island. So I don't know, let's enjoy this place and we'll move on to the next location. Yeah, you heard about me. I'ma pop you like a pea, yeah, at a mommy. Yeah, feel so hot like I'm chilling on the beach. Yeah, baby in the sun like the Teletubbies. Sing a low while I pop a ball off of your chain swinging, clang clang, and it costs a lot. Bitch, I'm always at the quarter, yeah, and you are not bad as people. Yeah, hit the spot, whoa. I'm a big bag hunter with the bow. She got a big bed, never drop it low. Mama called me and she happy with the grow. Never ever fall for a party that's a hobby. Hello down there. Hello. I know that we ain't getting along, but I wanna see you on your own tonight. Girl, D&D your phone. I'm tryna get you on your own tonight. Bad and you know it. You tell me that you with it, gotta show me now. Mix Hennessy with emotions. I'm tryna let go, can you hold me? Hello y'all, welcome to the third spot. Now this is Cow's Beach slash Pier, because they're right next to each other. Now it is a Sunday, so it is quite busy, and it is also,
oh my god, it's raining.
I think everyone's packing up and everything. Oh, everyone's running off the pier.
I smelt the rain before I even came.
You what?
I just smelt the rain.
I think most people are pier jumping today because it's hot and all the kids are out, but usually, yeah, this would be a good fishing spot. Now we are eating here with Mum, okay, and Wendy. We're having a little picnic here. Hopefully this rain passes and we don't get drenched. And if the time permits, maybe I'll do a little bit of fishing. But yeah, see you guys in the next one.
So this jetty was actually built in the 1870s and still remains as the focal point of Cowes. This place is among the top 3 most popular fishing destinations at Phillip Island and one of the best places to go pier jumping. Now, on to the next location. Baby bet, ay, couple racks, ay, couple Grammys on him, couple plaques, ay, that's a fact, ay, throw
welcome to Red Rock Beach. Now, as the name implies, it's got red rocks. It's a beach. Don't know what else to say.
There's also a lot of dogs here.
Now, unlike Cow's Beach, this place is a lot less dense. So if you prefer like a more quiet, you know, to yourself kind of place, come here instead. Nice. Need me like one with Nicky now. Tell a rap nigga I don't see ya, huh? I'm a pop nigga like Bieber, huh? I don't fuck bitches, I'm queer, huh? But these nigga bitches let me deal. Yeah. Hey, holy do it. I ain't fall off, I just ain't release my new shit. I blew up and everybody tryna sue me. You call me Nas, but the hood call me Doobie. And this one is for that. What are you collecting there? Why are you collecting so many? So that's it for this place. On to the next attraction. Welcome to the fifth location. So we're here at Kitty Miller's Bay, and what's special about this bay is that there is actually a shipwreck here. So the ship that was wrecked is called the SS Speke, or Speak. I'm not too sure how to pronounce it, but it ran aground in 1906, which is quite a long time ago. If you want to go to the lookout point where you can see the ship, it's actually a 1 and a bit kilometer walk down this uneven trail. Now, this trail is only accessible at low tides when there's no water up here, and thankfully there's no water right now, which means we can go take a little look at the ship. At the time, the ship was one of the largest of its kind, but it was no match for the Bass Strait. We can still see the remains of the ship scattered around the bay, reminding us that the sea is a very, very dangerous place. Alright, that is it for this location. I'll see you in the sixth and final must visit.
No more.
Later.
Fuck the rules.
Welcome to the sixth location. Well, kind of. So the sixth thing that you must do at Phillip Island is visit all the wildlife. Now there's three separate places that you need to go. So the first place is going to be Penguin Parade, which is going on right now because it happens at 8. The second thing that you need to go to is a sea life tour where you can go and see the seals and dolphins when they're around. And then the third thing is the wildlife sanctuary, which is where you can see the koalas, kangaroos, all that sort of stuff. We decided not to go to the penguin place because of COVID reasons, there being a lot of people and such in there, didn't feel safe. So we decided to come to the end where the seal rock is and just watch the sunset here.
Fucked up, I was wasted. Midsummer madness, I can't take it no more. No more. Fuck the rules.
Hello. Hi, nice to meet you.
Oh yes, I do meet you too.
So what you doing here?
I'm just looking for food.
I found this really nice. Oh, this is really nice. This is so good.
Okay, I'm leaving now.
Okay. Alright, Wendy, say goodbye.
Oh my god, they're gonna kick us.
They're gonna kick us out. Run!
Alright, that is it for the video today. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe if you want to see part 2, where we look at another 6 things to do at Phillip Island. Obviously, we only had a day here, so we couldn't do everything. There's much more to explore here. It is a tiny island, but it's full of adventure. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.